in a tree. Can you all see the tree? It's a beautiful tree. It's a banyan tree. It's called Bharat Chaur. It was morning in Bharat Chaur. But it was not the normal morning. Unni. Unni is the owl. Unni was staring at something in the distance. Wait a minute. It was morning, and Unni, the night owl's eyes were open. Rakshas. Unni announced to Ali. Everyone began to talk at once, nervously. Lohe ke Rakshas, he said. Insan hamla karne wale. Wo hamare ghar ko tehas nehas kar dalne wale. Unke bade bade lohe ke taar hamare pet ko kaat karenge. वो केकड़ा राक्षस अपने बड़े बड़े जबड़ों से धरती को चीर कर इन जड़ों को उखाड़ गया और वो भारी भरकम बेलन राक्षस इस जमीन को पापड़ की तरह फेंक दिया. जस्ट देन एवरीवन हर्ड अ टक 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 साउंड ऑन द ट्री. With a fierce-looking moustache, he was walking around the tree, knocking on the bark, measuring the trunk. Ali, hamara waqt samapt hua Ali, ab hame koi bacha nahi sakta, said Unni. Aur ye kehte hue, Unni shut his eyes very sadly. Ali dropped down next to Unni. He said, "Bhagwan hume bana sakta hai? Bhagwan?" Unni asked, his eyes snapping open. Ali said, "Mere abbu na, madari ke bandar the. Wo apne ustad ke saath team ke chhat wale jhopdi mein rehte the. Ek din aise hi rakshas unki jhopdi ke chitne karne aaya. Abbu ke ustad ne bhagwan se prarthna ki. Aur phir abbu ne kaha, wo rakshas pata nahi kaise bhag gaye. Aur un sab ki jhopdi us din bach gayi." Ali tells Unni, "मैं भी उस मंदिर में जाकर प्रार्थना करूंगा." Jalebi, the snake, asked, "इंसान के भगवान को?" Gillering, the squirrel, asked, "वो हम जानवरों की मदद क्यों करेगा भाई?" Farfari, the parrot, asked, "वो पक्षियों की मदद क्यों करेगा? वो तो इंसान का भगवान है." "कोशिश में कोई हर्ज नहीं," said Ali, and saying that, he leapt off the branch and he ran away from. He swung from tree to tree, he swung from pole to pole, he bounded across rooftops, he scampered across roads, he ran through lanes, he went across the city looking for a temple, until he could hear a ting 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 sound. And he heard some voices singing. Abbu kaha karte the? Ali thought, ki insaan jo hai na, apne bhagwan ke samne gana gaata hai. He thought that and he swung faster and faster towards the sound until he reached a temple where a priest was ringing a large bell. Tang dang, tang dang, tang. Ali looked around. Suddenly, right there in the front row, his eyes shut tight, his palms clasped together, his lips moving, was the man with the fierce-looking moustache in the temple, Mr. Moochwala. He was chanting, "Jai Bajrang Bali, Jai Bajrang Bali," feverishly. Startled, up, lost his grip and landed on his head. He scurried into a corner, thinking to himself, "Mr. Moochwala bhi is Bhagwan ko manta hai, so ye Bhagwan zarur damdar hoga." At this, he turned to look at the idol, and he froze. The god was a bandar. Ali thought, ye toh bilkul mere jaisa hai. He hid behind the god and then he waited for all the people to leave the temple. Once the temple was empty, he went and stood before the monkey god. "To ye hai unke Bajrang Bali." Ali looked at Bajrang Bali from bottom to top, from top to bottom, inspected him. Ali puffed up his chest, stiffened his tail, stuck out his bottom, and he said, "Main Ali, hu Bajrang Bali." And he giggled. And just then, an idea flashed in his head. Ali turned to the monkey god, lowered his head, closed his eyes, clasped his palms together, just as he had seen Mr. Moochwala do, and then he said, "Jai Bajrang Bali." Just then a bell went thump. Bajrang Bali had spoken. Idea. Now, there were just two things Ali needed for this man. And he knew just where to get them. Now, behind Bargat Chowk, every year was a Ram Leela. And the Ram Leela was being performed again this year. He ran into that little Maidan and his eyes searched everywhere. He looked at Ram, he looked at Lakshman, he looked at all the people who were there. They all had a mukut and they all had a kalam. But they were all acting. How is he going to steal it from them? And then he saw him. Man with 10 heads. Fast asleep. Who is the man with 10 heads?
Yeah.
He was fast asleep. Beside him was a mace. And a crown was slipping off one of his 10 heads. He screamed at his officers. And when he looked up, he said, "Bajrang Bali?" And his moustache started quivering. The engineers all looked at him and at each other, confused. Seeing the look on their faces, he pointed to the window and said, Dekho, dekho. Everyone looked. There was no one there. Mr. Moochwala rushed out, but he saw nothing. He was shaking. What did he see? That evening, on his way home, a very scared Mr. Moochwala, he stopped by Bargat Chowk. When he came by the tree, to take the bat who was hanging upside down, he said, "Kahi ye wo tak 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 aadmi to nahi?" The squirrel Dillery nodded. They were all very scared. Chupke, the other bat hanging upside down, said, "Tujhe dar lag raha hai. जलेबी रसली लगता है इसको किसी का डर नहीं." Just as Mr. Moochwala was going to leave, the branches of the tree shook vigorously. He looked up. Something sparkled between the leaves. Suddenly his eyes grew rounder and rounder. Mr. Moochwala fell to his knees, clasped his palms and lowered his head. Hillary, Tukke, Chukke, Jalebi, they all looked up to see what he looking at. It was Ali, a crown on his head, a mace in his hand, standing on the uppermost branch of the tree. Like, what was he looking like? Bajrang Bali. That night, Mr. Moochwala in his house was trying very hard to sleep. But he was having very bad dreams. He tossed and he turned. When he finally fell asleep, he had a very bad dream. In his dream, Bajrang Bali came and he said, "Bargat ko chhuna bhi mat, samjhe? Nahi to main tumhari moonch ko aise aag laga dunga jaise maine Lanka mein lagaya tha." Jai Bajrang Bali. Bajrang Bali, Mr. Moochwala, very scared, covered his moustache protectively. He is very scared to lose his moustache and he tried to go back to sleep. Next morning, a very tired Mr. Moochwala. Why is he tired?
He couldn't sleep.
Why could he not sleep?
He got a bad dream.
He was back in the office. He was in a very bad mood. And he said, "Ye plan, cancel it." He said, as his three engineers stood before him, shaking in their shoes, "Isse bhadda road plan maine zindagi mein nahi dekha. Kis idiot ne sanction kiya?" Sir. You're fired. Now, even the bucket girl once again into the morning, and once again, only the night owl's eyes were open. Hari, Rakshas,
Jaarani,
greeted happily as Jalebi, Dillari, and Sindaru, Bukke and Chukke, Anguri, Parthani, Chukki, and Chatter Patal were washing. Ali couldn't stop dancing. Suddenly, somebody yelled. As he was celebrating, somebody suddenly yelled, "Jai Bajrang Bali!" And everyone got a start when they heard a sound. Katak! Mr. Moochwala smashed a coconut at the foot of the tree.
That!
He clasped his palms together, closed his eyes and said, "Mujhe maaf kar de Bajrang Bali. Mujhe nahi maloom tha ye aapka ghar hai." And up in the tree where he was, Bajrang Bali, looking splendid, the monkey god raised his hand and blessed him. What did Mr. Moochwala do? He placed a big bunch of banana. Ali was very happy. Now not only did he save the tree, he will get his fill of bananas every day. Ali stopped his mouth with one banana. Then he ate two. Then he ate three. He said, "Bas karo." And then he said, "Jai Bajrang Bali."
Too proper.
But nobody knew that someone somewhere was still fast asleep, and he was not missing his crown and his voice. Hello, children, stay back.